in America's election headquarters tonight, rumblings about some new entries in the Republican presidential sweepstakes. Chief political correspondent Carl Cameron is chasing those down tonight. Good evening, Carl.
Hi, Brett. Well, that rumbling is really more from Republican voters who just aren't happy with their current 2012 presidential choices, if you believe the polls. And that has former New York Mayor Rudy Giuliani flirting with yet another go. He's toying with testing the waters in New Hampshire, right around the 10-year anniversary of the September 11th attacks later this year, to see if he can just catch on in the Granite State. Giuliani's a pro-choice social moderate, which is a tough sell in the GOP, but independents can vote in New Hampshire's primary, so Rudy's calling around to gauge the enthusiasm. A candidate who officially entered the race just this Saturday, businessman Herman Cain, had a pretty rough start. In his Fox News Sunday interview, Cain was unaware of Palestinian demands for a right of return to their homeland, or that Israel has big misgivings about it. Cain had some cleanup to do last night on Hannity.
I didn't even conceive of him asking me about the right of return. I now know what that is. The thing that you're going to learn about Herman Cain, if he doesn't know something, he's not going to try and fake it or give an answer that he doesn't know what he's talking about.
That's not something you hear on TV very often from a candidate. And we also have a new hopeful eyeing run, four-term Congressman Thaddeus G. McCotter of Michigan, which, not coincidentally, is Mitt Romney's home state. Take a look there, Mitt. McCotter's a 45-year-old Gen Xer, a cultural conservative, a rock and roll guitar player with a small but growing following. He's known for a razor-sharp, dry wit and even managed to work a Led Zeppelin lyric into a recent floor speech. He could really shake things up if he gets into the race. And finally, Brett, former Pennsylvania Senator Rick Santorum, who's been exploring since March, plans to officially join the race the week of June 5th. Brett.
Fun to follow. Carl, thank you.